Ergonomics really has been a decision at Ford to integrate it into our engineering process. So all of our products now are delivered to the manufacturing engineering group in a virtual. They're not actually as hard parts. So all of our assessments now of whether or not we can build it have moved from this physical trying on and does it fit to using the virtual tool set. And that's where we took advantage of the motion capture technology. It allows us to bring in the virtual data set that you see up on the screen, same as the engineers are using, and allows us to immerse someone in the environment so that they can see the design, and then we can assess whether or not they could reach it, whether or not there's enough hand clearance, whether or not there's enough strength to put it on using a digital human model. Because we have it so integrated and need to do so many studies, the use of the motion capture allows us quicker simulation time and, we believe, accurate simulation. So if you're creating a simulation at your workstation, you use your experience on how you would move the mannequin. At any point within a movement, I can go in and say, what is the stress on the spine? What is the compression force on the spine? What is the shear moments generated at the spine? What are the torques generated at the shoulder? So that's all that cool ergo data that we use to say that that would be an acceptable job or not acceptable due to the stress on each of the joints. So that's the key of getting the motion, which is what they use in the movie industry, into a scientific model, biomechanical model, so that we can do our analysis to be acceptable or unacceptable on the assembly line.
One of the challenges we had on the Focus is the two different body styles, the four-door and the five-door. This is the four-door version here with an actual trunk to it that posed some challenges for things that had to go on inside the trunk from the rear end. One of the things we had to do was put a gas strut and connect the hood, part of the hinge on the hood, to the back of the package tray. This helps dampen the opening and closing of the trunk. So it has a real important functional purpose. When I first took a look at this AutoCAD and where this location was on the vehicle, I thought, oh, that doesn't look like a posture I would want to be in 70 times an hour or 8 hours a day. So I did a static model and couldn't get the mannequin to actually reach it. And that's the beauty of the motion capture. When we suit up Patty here, you can get a bit more detailed with the motions that the human can make. You can stretch a little bit, you can turn a little bit more. I could spend a lot of time doing it with a static model, but you can do it a lot quicker with a dynamic model. So I brought it in here and had Patty give it a shot. What we had to do was attach this strut to a ball stud deep inside the trunk, which is represented by this spot right here. This bar right here represents the back of the package tray, which is a head knocker. This spot right here represents the back of the back panel and the bottom of the trunk opening. So those were kind of hard spots we had to make sure we could get around.
We've seen two big benefits. One is our quality improvements because we're a plan for every part. So that's been very exciting for the company. And then to your point, we've also seen a dramatic improvement in our ergonomic type injuries, our strains and sprains. So when we first kind of were looking at the data, when we first got some of our injury, we saw almost an 80% reduction. The exciting part for us is we have good, clear direction of how to design for a global workforce, and that we are also bringing the standard so that all of our facilities around the world will all be accessible to any of the individuals on the assembly line. And I think that's part of our quality story in terms of being able to, we know they can reach it, we know they're gonna have enough strength to put it on, we know a hand can get access to it, and our strategy now allows us to take that to all the manufacturing facilities, which is really exciting.